And I'm Kathy Davini.
And we are here with your Bradley Beat.
And we're so excited to have Lucy Reimer back. She's been in quarantine and we have missed her so very much.
Yes, I'm excited to be here. I was, you know, getting a little tired of living inside my own little walls for, gosh, it was like 2 weeks because when Elise got exposed and then it kind of ran through our whole family. So we were stuck inside for quite a while. So it's really good to be back.
And we're going to celebrate her exciting birthday when she feels better.
Yes, yes. When I can smell and taste again, we'll eat some cake.
That's very exciting. Yeah. So what was your highlight from being at home for 2 weeks?
Sleep.
Was that a good thing?
That's a good thing.
My friends all know this when they say that to me. I always say I'll sleep when I'm dead.
Yes, I understand that. No, it was a good thing to be at home and, you know, really just to be with the family and the kids because, you know, we homeschooled last year and we've all kind of missed it a little bit. So it was nice to be there and be with my girls and kind of be together when we were feeling well.
So your child got it.
Yes.
Then your husband got it.
And then you got it.
But your other child never got it.
She went and she lived in our basement.
And she's basically the only one that didn't have a shot.
No, she did. She had her, Elise is the only one, the one that got it first. She's the one that wasn't vaccinated. My daughter, Sophie, she got her first shot on her birthday, which was August 28th. So she had 2 weeks for it to kind of kick in. And then, you know, it must have worked for her very well.
Good.
She's gotten her second shot now and she's all vaccinated. But that child, she's 12. And she would not, I mean, she's like, I will cook for myself. I will take care of myself. Do not come near me. And so she lived on peanut butter and jelly sandwiches and microwavable mac and cheese for a couple weeks. But she is somehow, you know, she never got sick.
That's great.
Yeah, yeah. From the COVID or just from malnutrition.
That's great.
We're all better now.
Tell us what's going on with the museum, because I know you have been hit with 1,000 things since you have been back.
It has been wild. Of course, you know, first I want to acknowledge, you know, we had to postpone the gala, which was
really sad about that
for all of us, but we have rescheduled it for January 15th. So I think that's going to be a good thing for multiple reasons. I think there's going to be less COVID around. I think people won't have so much on their schedules, you know, then in January, and it's a Saturday. So there are a few people that were not going to be able to come.
Maybe I can lose weight.
Come then. Yes.
By then.
We have time to fit into our gala dresses even a little bit better. But it's still going to be the same great party. We've got the same auction items. Everybody who purchased a ticket or a table, they're, you know, all of that will still be honored. It's just a few weeks down the road. And so we are looking forward to that at that time. But, you know, right after we postponed the galas, when our COVID numbers locally, it spiked. And it was the highest numbers we'd ever had. So I think we made the right decision. And now, you know, of course, numbers are going down. And I hope that maybe our postponement maybe played a role in that, and it makes me feel better to think that anyway. So anyways, we will see you in January. You can still buy gala tickets. We still have room. If anybody out there wants a table or a ticket, you can still get them online at museumcenter.org, and we hope to see you then. And of course, this week now, because we couldn't draw a raffle ticket last week, we got approval from the state to draw it this weekend at our outdoor concert, Music Under the Stars, which is happening. The weather is going to be marvelous. It's going to be like a high of 72, I think.
It's going to be great.
On Saturday, sunny, a perfect fall day. So
now tell everybody what Music Under the Stars is.
Yes, Music Under the Stars is an outdoor concert at the museum. It's featuring the Premier Jazz Orchestra, which is a 17-piece big band. And they're made up of all guys from, you know, this region, Cleveland, Chattanooga, surrounding areas. And they are fantastic. So if you want to come to Music Under the Stars, you can pay $10 and bring your own chair and your picnic basket if you want, or we will have food trucks there, and Misfit Tacos will be there as well. So we have food vendors if you don't want to carry your food with you. You can sit in our yard. You can listen to the music. We have Unity Dance Studio coming to do free swing dance lessons prior to the show, starting at 6 p.m. So you can come learn a little bit about swing dancing, enjoy some jazz music. If you are, you know, feeling like a little VIP that night, night. We do have some VIP tickets for sale. Those are $100 each instead of $10. So there's quite a price difference, but it does include all your food and all your drink for the night. And you know, on our patio and our VIP section, we'll have tables and chairs already set up for you. So it's just a little bit different of an experience depending on what you want to do. And it's a casual, come as you are event, family friendly. My kids are coming with me. I think we are going to allow pets too into the courtyard, which I will only say, if you are going to bring your dog, make sure they're okay with loud music, make sure they're okay with a large crowd, and that they're well behaved and you pick up after them. So if you come with your rowdy dog, you and your rowdy dog will have to leave. But if you come with your precious angel of a dog,
like mine,
you like yours,
but it's too
or
loud
like
for
mine,
mine,
it's too loud for mine too. Yeah. Ridge would be howling along with the band. It wouldn't work out well. But we are going to draw our raffle tickets at intermission, so you still have today and tomorrow to get your raffle tickets.
And
somebody's going to win big.
You do not have to be present to win.
You
we
do
need to
not
make sure.
have to be present to win. Don't let that's you know, I can't make it to the concert Saturday night, so I'm not going to buy a raffle ticket. Don't let that stop you, because we will be sure if your winning ticket is drawn, you will know it, and you can still come get your money.
I think this is an amazing opportunity. If you have not been around a 17-piece orchestra, it's a great opportunity for you to go, and certainly to expose children that would normally not have that opportunity.
Yes, absolutely. It's going to be a fun night. It's
going to
be great music, and at a $10. Where can you go and hear a concert?
Not even the movie.
$10.
Not even the movie.
You can't even, go to the movie. And, I should mention, kids 12 and under are free. So
you can spend that $10 at the food truck.
You could spend $20 for you and your spouse and your 15 kids and see a concert. You know?
I'm just
it's a great deal. Everybody should come out. Come see the music. So we've got that going on. And then on October 2nd, I'm really excited about, we have a National Youth Summit coming up. It's part of the Smithsonian's National Youth Summit, and we're a regional summit host, one of only 12 in the United States. So it is an honor to be able to host this summit. It is about gender equity, and we have got an amazing panel of women that are coming to talk about breaking gender barriers. So we've got Sharon Couch, who is an Olympic track and field athlete. She competed in two different Olympics. She's coming, and we have got Beth Jenkins, who is the plant manager for Watts Bar Nuclear,
nice.
Which is, amazing. I'm so excited to have her. Sergeant Evie West is coming from the police department. We have Jody Walters from Element coming to talk about fashion and how, gendered expectations on fashion have changed for women over, the course of forever.
And men.
And men, too. And let's see, we've got Marsha McKenzie, Councilwoman Marsha McKenzie coming, and a Councilwoman, Raquetta Dotley from Chattanooga, who's also the Executive Director of the Net Resource Foundation, which helps with, children in bad parts of town.
Okay.
Down there. Kind of like the Boys and Girls. Well, not really like the Boys and Girls Club. What am I thinking? Anyways, the COVID brain fog still has me. I'm still working on getting my mind back together, obviously. Who else do we have coming? I think that is it. And it's going to be, we've got Megan McKnight, who's the director for the Center of Wellbeing at UTC, and then our moderator is Sarah Peters, who is the director for the Center of Women's and Gender Equity at UTC as well. So, a great panel
of
amazing
exactly
women.
Do we mean by gender equity?
So, that is things being fair and balanced, I would say, between men and women. It is saying, there aren't sports that are just for boys. Or men, that a girl can be a skateboarder or a basketball player or even a football player, just like a boy can. With fashion, it doesn't mean that, women are supposed to wear dresses and wear pink. that years ago, part of this exhibit that this follows along with is called Girlhood, It's Complicated. And it has pictures in the exhibit of what women were expected to wear to gym class like years and years ago, and it was like a dress with tights, you know, nice. And that's what they were expected to play in. Well, obviously that doesn't work very well, you know. It's talking about, you know, women can go and be engineers and scientists and mathematicians just like men can. So it's the question it poses is, what does the future of gender equity look like? And this is really, I'm going to say, a girl power kind of event. So I hope people will come out. It is targeted towards middle and high school aged students. We say it's all about girl power, but men are welcome too. Not men, boys, I guess they are men, depending on young men and ladies. Everybody is welcome to come and talk about this issue, because it's not one that just affects women. It affects men as well. So I hope people will come out and take part in it. It is a free event. It's on October 2nd at 10 a.m. at the museum. So come out and join us for that.
Nice.
Mm-hmm. All right. So what else is going on around town?
So tonight at Silver Springs Winery, you know, one of my most favorite places to go, is the night they have a band outside, Remix.
Okay.
They come every month and they play music 60s, 70s, 80s. So, of course, my group is all usually in with that. But we can't make it this week. So you guys go and have a good time for us. Mm-hmm. The Better Business Bureau's Golf Classic at Windstone is on the 29th, and I think they have a few tee times left at 8 and 1. The Cleveland Apple Festival, October 16th and 17th. And today, I'm super excited to have Paul Wyrick here.
I know.
Paul
Wyrick.
We've
been looking forward to Paul Wyrick coming for months.
He is one of my most favorite athletic, hardworking friends, and he has gotten himself, as usual, overly involved with the new program called New Adventures Club. Mm-hmm. You guys may have seen it in the paper. He's gotten all kinds of things going with that, so he is going to tell us about the New Adventures Club in addition to the many athletic programs that he has going on.
It's great to have a Parks and Recreation Department that offers so much to our community in so many ways.
They are critical to a healthy active community, and they work so hard and do so much for so many people.
Yes.
So we'll be right back with Paul Wyrick.
All right, sounds good. And we're back
with Paul Wyrick.
All right. Hey, Paul, how are you?
I'm good. It's a good day.
It's a beautiful day to be outside and doing something with Parks and Recreation, right?
By far the best day we've had all year, it seems like. It's just about a nice 48 degrees and a little bit of breeze.
And I know the tennis courts and the pickleball courts are packed.
Oh, yeah. We've had a busy spring with adult softball, pickleball, tennis, a lot of great programs this spring, summer, fall. This fall. Mm-hmm.
All the time.
Yeah, all the time. Yeah,
you have had record numbers of people enrolled in every sporting event.
Yes.
People constantly trying to get going on new things. We've had a lot of people even coming in from Chattanooga to get involved in programs.
Yeah.
So what sports can people play with Parks and Rec?
Well, right now we have adult softball, we have adult tennis, and we have pickleball, of course. Mm-hmm. So right now, those are the three things that are going on right now. Of course, we want to develop more programs for adults too as we go. I'd really like to get an adult men's basketball league.
And soccer.
Soccer. Soccer is definitely a thing too. So hopefully in the future we can add some more things.
Because you need some more things to do. Yeah. I worry about you having enough to do.
Oh, yeah. It's hard to find something to do around here. It really is. But it's great to see everybody out again, and went through the COVID thing, and it really just, I think people got a lot more involved in activities outside, and we've seen a big jump in our numbers and our population too. So, yeah, we've had big spring adult softball. We had 23 teams. We usually don't have that. So,
my goodness. And so these are all just people. Is this like churches that have formed teams? And
churches, manufacturing companies, and groups of friends. It's been really great. It really is. It's a lot of fun. So
I love to see the new friendships that form through teams. So Paul has started a new tennis program, and the most exciting thing about it is we have people coming from all over making friends with people in Cleveland, and playing and having fun and getting to enjoy our beautiful facility,
right.
which makes the other people want to be more involved in Cleveland and do more in Cleveland because they're comfortable, because you guys make such an inviting environment for people to want to come and play.
Yeah, that's where the city council and the mayor and city manager all have been very important to develop of our recreation facilities.
It's important.
They've really improved Deer Park. AJ Park is a new development. They put money in the tennis courts, pickleball courts, and there's more things on in the future too. So we're very very lucky to have a city council, mayor, and city manager that's very progressive and updating a lot of things that needed to be done. And it's paying off big dividends. It really is. People are noticing.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. All the people that are coming from out of town, mm-hmm. definitely. They walk in and they say, wow, I had no idea Cleveland offered this kind of facility. I hear it all the time.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And we're becoming a more of a regional, I guess, destination. As far as last year, before COVID got us in basketball, I had teams signed up from McMinn, Polk, Meigs County. Some of our summer camps, we've had people from Ottawa. So we are a regional spot destination mm-hmm. That people do look to.
So if you wanted to get involved with playing tennis or pickleball, how would you do that? If you're just not a part of a company or a church or anything that has a team, you're just a random individual.
ClevelandTNParks.com. That's the website to go to for all the information, all the contact information, all the program information, the registration, things like that. You can contact me at Cleveland Parks and Rec, 423-479-4129, or just a simple email, pywyrick@ClevelandTNParks.com.
That'd be great.
It's really, the website is very well done. It's easy to follow. You can click on adult and then you can click on whichever program you're interested in. And if you have a problem with it, they are very good to help you through that website, because sometimes the dates will close and then people can't get registered, but it's just a matter of changing the date and then you can get registered. So don't ever feel like it's closed and I can't get involved. We're always happy to have anyone come and get involved wherever you're from.
Yeah.
So tell us a little bit about this new Adventures club that Kathy was talking about earlier.
Well, you know, we have a great community. We have a lot of passionate people about a lot of things, and Kathy being one of them as far as tennis. And, you know, we kind of got together and she was very adamant about getting that going. So, you know, I tend to work with pretty passionate people. And we had a lady came through my office, Donna Botterbush, and very passionate about this great program they had in Thomasville, North Carolina.
Mm-hmm. She's a new resident.
Yeah, okay. And just a go-getter. Mm-hmm. So, and I realized that right off the bat, and I'm like, hey, you know, it's like I told Patty, we can try it. If it works, fine. If not, fine. So, and Donna's been very active. She's coordinated all of it, and I've just been there to support her, really. And she's came up with a great plan as far as programs, activities, day trips, afternoon stuff, events, and we've gotten with Kathy. There's a group of us that talk about just different events that we're going to go to and try to bring people together that maybe aren't from here, just recently moved, empty nesters, may have had a
retiree.
Sounds like I need her to get involved at the museum.
No, she's you'll meet her today.
Oh, good.
Yeah, you'll meet her today. She's a very active lady, so you know, and she's put a lot of time into this, and a lot of great things are going to come out of it. It'll take a little time, but hey.
Every meeting, and I believe I missed the one yesterday because it wasn't a meeting. It was a tour that Andy gave at the library, and I would have loved to have seen the history tour at the library. But one of the super positive things about this group is with every single meeting, there are different people.
Yeah, even yesterday.
It is encouraging people that are not involved in our city to get involved. And with Paul's vision and Donna's vision of having different avenues through this club, you wouldn't say, oh, well, I'm not interested in this, but you might be interested in that. So I know that they have partnered with Lee University to go to theater night with different restaurants in town. So it's a great way to use local businesses and business owners to work together to bring this group of people along, because this group is going to grow continuously, and get to do lots of differing events.
Yeah, some really great events.
Tell them about that trip.
Yeah. First of all, October 13th, we're just taking a day trip down to Red Clay State Park. The park ranger is going to give us a tour. I've lived here for 32 years, and I've never been down there and really been told what the property's about. So, mm-hmm. I've been here for a long time, and that's something I really enjoy, like going to the library yesterday. Andy told us all the amazing things going on there. So we're going down to Red Clay October 13th and visit that and get a lot of history and information there. So, and then October 27th, we'll be having Dr. Miller from Cleveland Chiropractic come in, talk about health and balance and nutrition. That's going to be a great class.
Is that at the library?
Yep. I believe it'll be at the library. November 5th, we're going to that Sense and Sensibility.
Sense and Sensibility.
The theater. And then we're having a dinner before, aren't we? And
we are having a dinner at the Bistro.
So we'll have a little dinner at
True.
Yeah, okay. True. Yeah. We're going to go to True, like a pre-show event, and then go over to the Sense and Sensibility from the Lee Theater, right?
They are giving us a wonderful package, so you need to get on getting registered for that, because you will get the ticket to the show, you'll be with the group, and you'll have a pre-theater warm-up all together in a special area at True.
This is wonderful. I think this is a great thing, especially if you're new to the community and you don't know a lot of people, and you like to get out and go do things, maybe not by yourself. Now you've kind of got like a set group of people that you can connect with. So that's wonderful. And how would you register if you wanted to go to these? Is it through Cleveland Parks?
ClevelandTNParks.com. Mm-hmm. We'll have all the information there, where you go to register and how you register. It's really neat. We've got something planned. You don't have to plan it or anything else. Donna does a lot of the homework, and so does Kathy, mm-hmm. Coming up with these events. And hey, you just register and show up, and come join some people. So it's really good. I think, when I first moved here and didn't know a soul, it would have been nice just to have something to go and do. And there's so much to do here, like all the amazing things mm-hmm. you do at the museum. It's a good way to tie into the community and learn something new. Even if you've been here 30 years, you will learn something new about your community every day. It's
absolutely
so wonderful.
I don't know if you guys are on the app next door.
Mm-hmm. I'm not personally, but I did just get some kind of notification for the museum. And so I think the museum mm-hmm. is now on there, but I don't know a lot about it. I need to figure it out.
Well, first of all, you guys both know that I am a computer dinosaur.
me too.
As dinosaur as it gets, that's me. But on Nextdoor, all of the people in your area, you will see every day there are people saying, hi, my name is this. I've moved here from New York. I don't know anybody. Can anybody recommend a place to eat or things to do? Mm-hmm. And every day there are people on that site saying that. And to me, that's what makes this club so important.
Right.
They may not go to Red Clay by themselves,
right.
but they'd go with a group. Or they might not venture to Lee if they've never been on the campus of Lee.
Right.
But they'll feel more secure going to the pre-party and then the show with a group of people. Mm-hmm. And even if they connect with one person out of the group, it's worth it.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
That's what it's all about, just connecting people. Everything we do is about connecting people, really, and that's what's so great about it.
And that's true with every sport. Paul reaches out. He spends tireless hours texting people and reaching out to people to make these things happen, because without all these hours behind the scene, mm-hmm. you wouldn't have the great competition that you have.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And then it's not worth your time to go out and not have it organized, or it's just such a fantastic service that we offer as a city through Parks and Rec to have this organized sport.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Because you can't just say, I love basketball, I'll just go shoot some hoops.
No.
You want to go and play. Yeah. And it's the same in tennis. You can't just go out and play tennis by yourself unless you're super fast.
Sure.
And I don't think anybody's that fast.
I mean, not just with sports, but with artists, like people that play instruments. Mm-hmm. Like my daughter, she plays the violin, and her teacher's always saying part of the great thing about this is playing with a group of people. That's what makes mm-hmm. it so much fun. So we do have groups like the Cleveland Orchestra and the Pops that, people can get involved with there, not just, sports, but I know that's not through Parks and Rec.
Well, no. And that's where we're trying to be diverse in what we're doing. We've got a dance program started at Black Power Elementary. We've got 24 girls registered.
That's great.
And through the Cleveland City Ballet, they meet after school on Thursdays, go to class. That's sponsored by the Cleveland Parks and Rec Department. It's been a great program. So as I work in this department, I want to be much more diverse in programming. So we do have, that's why the pickleball's for the older age group. Tennis is older.
I heard you say tennis is older. Yeah. You guys heard that.
I don't know but how tennis older covers... people can keep playing tennis because knees, my goodness. I've never been able to play tennis because of my knees.
But our tennis program goes from 5 to 65. I mean, that's the great
more
thing
than
about 65. Tennis.
Well,
I was... But anyway, so that's what I'm trying to do. We do want to do more arts and things like that, too. And we're going to. We're going to keep doing it. And, you know, going to these plays and shows, that ties into the arts. Mm-hmm. And we want to be more than just athletics.
A great after-school program that is to be able to stay there and do your dance classes or to extend it into music or some of these extracurriculars. I know that would be such a help to parents mm-hmm. to be able to just to have your kids stay in one place. Do whatever it is they want to do after school and then not have to be driving here, there, and everywhere.
Yeah.
You know,
especially
trying to
with
fit
multiple
in
children.
And, yeah.
Well, you know, these ideas come from very passionate people, like I was talking about with Kathy and tennis and Donna with the other program, the Persevia Crofts, the principal. You know, I spend time just talking to people and listening, and then you know where people's passion are. When you can tie into that, great things happen.
Absolutely.
And that's
absolutely.
An amazing program we've got because of Persevia, too.
Yeah.
And
well,
Connie Gowan.
It is. You've got some great people you're working with, it sounds like. And I'm seeing that we're almost out of time here for today.
Well, so let's hear about go ahead, Paul. Have you got?
December 14th, we're going to the Cumberland Playhouse, Scrooge the musical.
Mm-hmm. That'll be fun.
Anyway. That will be fun. And speaking of,
that's
this kind of ties in.
Yeah.
Scrooge the musical. We've got Holidays at Five Points coming up. We have just announced this yesterday. So hot off the presses, there's going to be a silent auction at the museum. It's actually before your holidays start. It's Sunday, November 14th from 1:30 to 4. And we are looking for people to donate handmade or handcrafted holiday items. It could be a tree that is no more than 4 feet.
It doesn't have to be handmade, does it?
Well, I mean, no, but you can buy something and bring it, I suppose. It's more fun if you make it yourself, but it could be anything. It could be a basket of gift cards, maybe, that people could use to do some holiday shopping mm-hmm. with. Or,
or it could be a tennis lesson.
It could be a tennis lesson.
Or a camp.
That would be a great...
Or a camp.
Or a camp. Yeah. Or, you know, something you could give somebody
well, that's why
for
you got
Christmas.
Me here.
Yeah, that's why Paul's here, really. We're plugging this event. And we need a donation, lots of donations.
That'll happen.
But we're hoping that, you know, a large part of the community will, you know, make something or donate something. And then for everything that you donate, you do get one free ticket to the event. If you want to just come to the event because maybe you're like me and you are not the craftiest of people. Tickets are just $10 a person. Kids are free. So you can come out. You can come to the silent auction on November 14th. But right now we are just trying to get people to
be aware.
Thinking about it. Be aware. Yeah. And we've already had a handful of people.
I know Laura Marks with Relic Antiques is already putting something
Roma
in.
Cafe Roma is putting something together.
Yes.
Somebody's donated a holiday wreath. I've had somebody call in about jewelry.
It's going to be exciting.
It's going to be exciting. It's going to be fun. It's going to be a family-friendly event, so I hope people will come out. And
Paul, maybe they'll put in a special locksmith package.
Yeah, there you go.
A locksmith package. That sounds fun.
Yeah. For when you lock your keys in the car.
Oh,
yeah. Yeah. This is my wife, that's the locksmith. There you go. Bring me the keys.
So we're very excited to see what people will donate. I hope you come out and... anyways, thank you so much, Paul Wyrick,
for
being
here today.
Thanks for having me.
It's always a pleasure to be with Paul Wyrick. He is amazing and inspiring.
Yeah.
I think he's inspiring.
All right, we'll catch you next time.
Looking forward to seeing you again on the Bradley Beat.
Yeah,